Hi everyone, good evening. Welcome to the last episode, that is the fifth episode of the Provider AI webinar series. Thank you for being throughout the entire series of five episodes. And today here we are to discuss around the data governance and the security measures that Provider AI provides to organizations and to the end as well as the users. So all our episodes are actually been published in YouTube. So you can subscribe to our channel and get access to all the videos if in case you have missed any of the session. So the today's episode, we will make sure to roll it out in our channel by tomorrow morning so that you can share and access that as well. So with this, we'll start today's the webinar. So hi, I'm Parvez here. So I've been a part of this webinar series throughout. So let's try to look into what we have discussed yesterday, that is on the fourth episode. So yesterday we were talking and discussing about the machine learning piece in Provider AI and how that helps and what are the features that it provides to the data scientists or ML engineers to work in Provider AI. So we started with the workflow, the approval flow for any machine learning model to be built, for which the users need to add and get it approved to start working on that. Once it is approved, the users can start building models, tracking the performance of the models, and as well as share the notebooks that has been built, and they can manage it at one central place. We then move towards discussing around deploying the models that has been built, and as well as accessing the model images, which are nothing but the Docker images, which can be later used to deploy it any other instances. So at last, we discussed about how what is the way to provide feedback to all these models that are present for improvements. And that's where we discuss around the ML monitor that we provide in Provider AI, where you can track down the performance of the model as well as provide the corrections, provide the feedback to the model response. And the third-party tools that are allowed to integrate to Provider AI for the machine learning piece are also been covered up. So today we are going to discuss about the governance and the security that we provide in Provider AI. So here we will talk around how we keep a place where you can manage all the users and also maintain their security, maintain their access as well. We provide 2FA for the users, the access. We have a granular level of access control where you can actually measure which user need to access what. So by creating roles, and these roles are defined by other policies. In details, we'll discuss in the demo. Then we will discuss around the workflow that already we've been discussing in the previous episodes as well. And then you'll be able to generate reports, share to the business leaders, business owners, some quick reports which will help you to give an entire brief of what has been going on in the platform and what users have been building. We also provide the security measures where you'll be able to track down all the accesses of users, who is doing what, and how threatful that can be. Data residency is a feature for where we make sure that depending on your request, we'll allow, we'll host the application accordingly so that you can take control of what IPs need to access the platform and what should be restricted. Auth connections are there, where all the AI tools that are connected to the platform can be directly accessed by the same authorized users without sharing the passwords. And API keys are there for the users who want to integrate to their own or any custom application they have built or any previous application they have. So we allow that as well. So in short, we'll be covering up these topics. So without wasting any time, let's start our demo session. Let me log in. Okay, we'll continue from where we left. So we started with, on day one, we started with discussing around idea, use cases, and how to track them in AI Overview. Then we discussed around the data management, covering up all the features available for data engineers, BI analytics to discuss around the features available for BI analysts or people who will be building dashboards and run some queries. Machine learning and MLOps has been discussed along with ML Monitor for data scientists and ML engineers kind of role in your organizations. And so today, once these assets have been built and you can track down in the AI Overview, so we'll start discussing like how, what are the other features and that we make sure that is helpful for the users, the team who keeps on building the assets, as well as the users who actually manages or runs the show, or who are actually in concern with the business. So we provide two features. One is the data policy. So there are various kind of documents, or there are various policies that keeps on running within our organizations wherever, whenever any team builds some solutions and try to share with them to the clients as well. So we provide a place where you can upload all the important documents, all the policies that are relevant to the solutions that has been built, and can share with to any team member within the platform, as well as download. So here you will be able to add these documents and also provide an expiry date, so that you can control who are actually using this document, and when is the limit that you want to restrict, like no one will be able to access the document, let's suppose after some date. And so therefore you don't need to keep sharing various important documents related to some solutions or related to some company policies via email or via some drive links. So better you can still put it in data policies and track it down from a central place. Next we have generate reports. Now for all the assets that has been built, be it IdeaPad, all the ideas, all the use cases or dashboards, data sources connected. So everything, no doubt they are in the platform, but for any quick purposes, for any quick overview, like what exactly you have that that's in the platform, this is more relevant for all the business managers, all the business leaders who just want to quickly have some idea of what is going on in the platform, so that they can take extract and start discussing around that. So let's suppose for data sources that already are in the platform, you can just check that, okay, let me check what are the data sources which are already approved, the approved data sources. So you'll then get a list of all the data sources which are approved, and then you can quickly download that as a CSV or as a PDF and right away go ahead for any business meets or to discuss in detail about these reports. So these two features are there for all the business people. So apart from that, now we'll go towards the user management and the access that we provide. So in user management in the platform, you'll be able to add users as well as depending on the subscription. So once you add user, you'll be able to also provide features like you can allow them to secure their logins by having 2FA. As well as you can activate or deactivate any user depending on their access. Like, so if suppose some user are no more in the organization, say they don't require access to the platform, you can simply deactivate them, and which will impact in the subscription as well. You can assign roles to the users, like for definitely there is a super admin who can actually access the entire feature of the platform. But we provide a very granular level of creating accesses or having accesses to the users, or providing access to the users, where you can create roles, any role, and then for any role you can actually give decide what that role should actually access. Let's suppose you have a role, and there you can actually decide what that role should access. For example, for any BI analyst, the BI analyst doesn't need don't need to actually have access to the machine learning model, let's suppose. So here you can simply opt out machine learning for the BI analyst. So then you will not even be able to access that in the entire platform. Now within that, even within that, we have made it and very granular. So for a respective feature in the platform, you will be again able to control like what are the actions they will be able to do. Like for example, if I'll just go back and show you. For example, as I said, a BI analyst doesn't need to even access machine learning. But even if you want to give him the access to machine learning, but still you are saying that okay, he will be just able to add models, but he will not be able to delete it. So you can control these accesses by these granular policies that we have provided in the access control. So n number of roles can be created and n numbers of policies can be assigned to that, so that it's very much customized for your users and you have control over their actions. So that's all about the access control as well as the user management. And that this is the same role that you create here, which will be eventually attached to the users when you create them. Now, coming to the security measures. So we provide two features. First of all is the cybersecurity, where we make sure, because the entire platform is based on the API endpoints, and we make sure that whoever are using the platform and whatever access, whatever actions they take, those are accessed, and those can be seen from a central place called cybersecurity. So here you'll be able to know who has been accessing what. Like for example, in here you'll be able to know, okay, just now I was going to securities, I was looking to roles just a few minutes ago. So every actions gets recorded here, and you'll be also able to track if there are any suspicious events or threats. Let's suppose I was talking about data residency initially in this episode. So that means you have defined that only users within this IP range can will be able to access this platform. So in that way, if anyone is accessing out of that range, so that will definitely be a suspicious event and will be recorded here, so that you know like what actions needs to be taken and who is responsible for that. Similarly, we have system audit where all the operations that has been done by your users. Let's suppose someone is building some assets, someone is building some models, dashboards, someone is approving even some of the requests, or someone is editing or deleting. So every action that has been taken by these users will be recorded in the system audit, where you will know like who is actually creating something, and if something goes wrong, you will be then able to track down and check with the user like why that was exactly done and what was the purpose. So that's how all the resources will be listed here, and you will know like who actually did an access at what time and what operations have been run on there. So with these two, you'll be having even as like I was saying, for user management and access control, you have the control of what they access and what they do. And here you'll be having the control of what they have been doing. And if something goes wrong, or then you'll be able to track down easily. Now, coming to other features, one of them is the OAuth settings. This is nothing but the entire platform already has, as like I was showing you earlier, like we have other tools that are already integrated to the platform. Start with the superset where we were discussing around how to build dashboards on that. We have Jupyter that has been connected where we build notebooks, and there are other tools as well to for different purposes. So now all these tools are connected via OAuth, because this actually helps you in the security features, because you don't need to share passwords, and here all the authorized users will be able to directly connect using the authentication protocol. So here you'll be able to add an application, and for example, let's suppose for the Jupyter, you'll be add this connection here, and then you'll be able to add assignee. Like even now here you'll be able to control like if your Jupyter or suppose Superset, where you'll be building dashboards, are connected to the platform, then also you'll be able to access like who are the users who exactly can log into the platform via OAuth connections. For example, if I suppose select myself and my fellow being as well, so only these two people will be able to log into Jupyter. So all the other users, not necessarily will be able to log into the connected platforms via OAuth. So that's how you measure, that's how you control the user actions and user access as well. So currently we provide the OAuth connections for all the tools that have been already connected for users to start with from day one. Now, coming to the next piece, which is very important, like all the assets that has been built in the platform. There are various possibilities, like in your organizations, you already have some applications where you are already managing or tracking down some of the events. And using Provider AI, you also want to see some of the results directly appearing into your application. So here, you can do the same by creating the APIs, by creating the API access from API key feature. Also, if you also plan to actually build a custom application and use these APIs to get the information there, you can also do that. For example, let's suppose you have models that already been built in your Provider AI application, but you want to provide your feedback to the models from your own custom application that you have in your organizations. So in those case, you'll be able to, you can just create an API key, and you can see the key here. And once you activate the API key, then you can also control like what are the endpoints that you are exactly for which actually you created the API. So that if, for example, here you are using an endpoint where you'll be able to provide feedback from your custom application or from your third-party application that whatever you have, and if it is connected, so then from there you will be able to provide feedback directly to the model in our ML monitor feature. So that's how API keys helps users create numerous number of APIs and get it connected to the custom application in the organization. So along with that, when it comes to some security features as well, we also provide a place where all the actions that has been taken in the platform, where you want to get it notified. Definitely, we have notifications which will definitely update the users for all the actions that have been done. But we provide a custom feature where you'll be able to choose what are the options that you want to select for getting updated. Let's suppose you want to get notified for every login instances whenever someone logins, or whenever someone suppose adds a new user to the platform. Adding a new user to the platform is something that definitely you want to check who got onboarded to the platform. So if you opt in, so you'll be getting an email directly so that you never miss any actions that happens in the platform, and whatever you think that those are necessary can be listed down here. So these are some of the measures that we took so that the users are updated as well as the business people. Now coming to the next important thing that we have been discussing from day one itself, that is the workflow. So already we discussed like how the approval flow plays a very important role in building assets, or as well as it gives a control to the business people to understand who are the resources that are working into, how many hours they have put, and how these hours are worth. Are they actually worth of doing that? They can control that as well. They can approve or reject accordingly. So, however, for the approvals coming from the asset or coming from the left navigation that we were discussing, you can also directly assign tasks from respective tasks directly to users from here itself. It need not to be only approval, but it can be some basic tasks as well. Like suppose you want your team, someone of the team member to actually generate reports for you. So you can simply create a task to and assign the user, and so and put a due date, and the task will appear for both of the assignee and the reporter. So that's how you'll be able to do that. And definitely for all the tasks, you are able to check like how many tasks are going on and how many new tasks can be assigned, and how many hours have been put to solve this, so that you understand like who is responsible to do what and what people have been doing and how much company hours have been spent on that and what's the benefit, what's the end result that you get. So in short, this is all about the governance and security piece. The last point, the most important actually, is about if sometime you actually want to close the subscription in the platform, and you then we provide a very transparent process so that you know that whatever data that you have created during the process of using the application, everything is transparent to you and you can download that. So for example, we are providing here four steps where you'll be able to download all your application data, also other data like some CSVs that you have stored, some models that you have built, everything can be downloaded. And also artifacts, like suppose for your user profile, you have got a profile picture or some other reports and files and images, everything can be downloaded. And then eventually you can close your account so that our team will help you close it as early as possible if you have actually gone through the previous three steps. And for all the supports that all the support tickets or the requests that are created to Provaito can be tracked down from support platform, where for any issue, for any request, you can directly create it here and Provaito will be available to the customer. The support team will be available for you to directly discuss here as well. And you can track down from here in the support phase. Also, last but not the least, you being as a user will also be able to update few of the information about you so that you can change your password if necessary, and also request for 2FA access if in case you don't have, and also track down like what exactly access you have in the platform. So in short, that's all about the governance and the security features that we provide to your organization so that you have a transparent idea about what is like what are the users that are using the platform, who has access to what, and what access needs to be given. And you can customize that, you can track down the events, you can also know who is doing what. So in short, you get a granular level access as well as a transparency in the actions that has been taken on your data that you have loaded. So I'll come back to the platform, so to the presentation and continue from there. So yes, it's available for you to subscribe the standard premium subscriptions. Premium, as I discussed, like it's a pay-as-you-go model where you can onboard your any number of users, start working on the platform, and have all the access to all the features that we've discussed. The standard still has limitations, but however, 10 users can start from day one using the platform. For any customized request or any enterprise level request to Provaito, can we request you to contact our sales team so that we can help you we can actually understand your problem and customize it accordingly and provide you as early as possible. The resources are there for all the early birds. Training sessions available for your users will be onboarded, so they have idea with respect to their roles and know what exactly needs to be done. The support team will be there for any issues faced by the users. And definitely the one-to-one consultations we are providing so that we understand your problem better and we help you onboard the platform, and so that you start getting benefits from the beginning. Now, what's next? Definitely, we are coming to the end of this webinar session. And however, the subscriptions are there. You can subscribe to our platform, start using it. And still, if you think that there are still some gray areas that you think that are not covered or you are not exactly sure, you can still connect to us, discuss with us. As well as you can actually register for our demo, where any user from your organization providing some details can start looking into the demo platform, start playing with the assets, start building assets. You can try to see how the entire things work and how that brings value to you. In case if you face any issues, you can also request for consultations. We'll definitely sit with you and understand the problem. But it's open for your demo. Just go ahead and unlock that, and all your users can start using it. the demo platform. So that's it from my side. It was a really nice series of all the 5 episodes, and I hope that was beneficial for you as well. And we will definitely come back with another series of episodes, maybe in the next 1 to 2 weeks. And there we will try to actually work on real use cases, where we will try to have more longer sessions where we will show for a specific use case how that will be beneficial. And we'll take up use cases like this time we were discussing around the insurance premium prediction problem. So where we started with the data and started discussing around building dashboards, models, deploying them. And definitely in the near future, we'll try to take up similar more problems so that if there is any relevant to you as well, so it will be interesting for you. So that's it from my side. If you have any questions, you can still ask. Okay, so I got a question related to AI Innovation Lab from a user. So AI Innovation Lab is something that you can definitely check in once you register for demo. So this is a place where we provide some of the pre-built solutions to our customers, where they can access to what solutions have been built in the platform. We also provide some research papers, some courses that has been built on topics of machine learning, topics of data science, and it's available for users so that their team members can also find it beneficial during the training sessions as well. So that is what about, in short, it's about AI Innovation Lab, which is open for our customers. So we request you to register for the demo so that you can access those resources as well. Okay, so I think I don't have any more questions. So thank you for joining the session. So we'll hope to see you again in the next series, and we'll keep you updated for that. Thank you.